For real? Tonight on Times for Schools Today, we will take a look at a class that is helping save lives.
And as always, we have a look at some of the events from around the school district. Times for Schools Today starts in 2 minutes.
Hello, and welcome to TRST Schools Today. For Thursday, February the 11th, I'm Shay Branda.
And I'm Liz Necker. Later on tonight, we see how one of the many teachers in high school East is doing a great job.
But up first tonight, we take a look at our elementary schools and our elementary happening segment.
For elementary happenings, please bring your food for donation to West Dover for Food Drive Friday. Your help can go a long way.
Let's take a look at today's random fact of the day.
Hi, I'm Steve Mister from TV21 with your random fact of the day. Did you know the original prototype for the Star Trek Enterprise spaceship was stolen from the creator Gene Roddenberry's unlocked van?
It's time to take a trip around the world on our 60-second road trip. Can you guess where we are today?
Touch the ground, and it feels like I can see the sands on the horizon at time. You are not around, slowly drifting away. Wave.
Let's take a look at the dictionary.com word of the day. Today's word is incumbent, meaning the holder of an office or ex-celestial. No.
Read from here.
Where? And now for today's sentence. The two-term incumbent has already raised almost $1 million for the upcoming congressional race.
Now we're going to take a short break, but coming up we take a look at our intermediate happenings.
And we also take a look at your weather, so stick around. We'll be right back.
outcasts and rebels, or anyone who just dares to be different. And you've been trying for so long to find out where your place is, but in their narrow minds, there's no room for anyone who dares to do something different. Oh, but listen for a minute. Trust the one who's been where you are, wishing all it was sticks and stones. Those words cut deep, but they don't mean you're all alone. And you're not invisible. Hear me out. There's so much more to life than what you're feeling now.
Welcome back. Starting off our intermediate happenings at Intermediate South, it's Seminole Spirit Day every Friday. Don't forget to wear your Seminole colors. Spirit Wear is on sale in the school store.
All students are reminded if they would like to see any sporting event at Intermediate South, you must go home first, then return at game time with an adult.
The cast of Shrek Jr. will be hosting a meet and greet character breakfast on Saturday, February 13th from 10 a.m. until 12 p.m. A great time for a little brother or sister. See the flyer for details.
Hey, 8th graders, don't miss the opportunity to submit your personal ad for the yearbook. See Ms. Stone and Ms. Andrews for an extra ad contract. 8th grade graduators, graduation gown money is due, $14 each. The cafeteria is selling fresh, delicious smoothies on Monday, Tuesdays, and Thursdays. Get one today, $1.50 each.
If your child is planning on trying out for a spring sport, physical forms must be handed into the nurse's office on or before February 12, 2016, in order for your child to be eligible to try out. This process takes 2 weeks after the physical has been turned into the office in order to make the deadline for sports tryouts.
At Intermediate North, now through February 19th, the Intermediate North PTO will be collecting orders for Gertrude Hall candy. Packets have been distributed, so please make sure to take a minute to look through the brochure so you don't miss out on ordering some delicious treats. All orders will be fulfilled in time for spring break and Easter. Prizes are available through Gertrude Hawk for sales volume, and the PTO will be offering 2 pretzel parties for each grade. So be sure to tell your family and friends. Any 6th graders interested in joining the art club with Miss Norton, please sign up outside room B2. The first 32 students will be in the art club, and then there will be a waiting list. First meeting will be Thursday, February 4th in B2 until late buses.
It is now time for our environmental tip of the day. Each day we bring you a tip that will help save the environment. Let's take a look at today's tip.
I'm Vinny DiStefano with TV21's environmental tip of the day. Remember, when you travel, stay at hotels that use less water or energy. Unplug your VCR or other electronics that use electricity even when off.
Every day on the show, we will bring you a tip of the day, so stay tuned tomorrow as we give you another way to help save the environment.
One of the most talked about moments of Saturday's Republican debate hosted by ABC were the awkward candidate entrances, so awkward that it got CNN's G Moose thinking about other not so grand entrances.
The desperate gestures of a backstage handler told the story of what one website called a chain reaction of cringe. Sure, it could have been worse. No one fell like Miss America. No one got a concussion like Conan did. Or tripped over a red carpet while singing their national anthem on skates. Nope, the debate introduction,
Chris Christie,
was just incredibly awkward. Starting when Ben Carson didn't respond to his name, for the obvious reason,
I couldn't hear.
And just when Carson seemed ready to advance,
Texas Senator Ted Cruz.
Ted Cruz cruised by, but Donald Trump likewise seemed to miss his name, letting
Jeb Bush
brush by with a tap and a see you later guys expression.
And that is something you will never see again, Jeb Bush passing Donald Trump.
When the moderators finally introduced
the Republican candidates,
only four were there. Chris Christie volunteered.
Can I introduce
Casey? It's so noisy in here. Yes, yes.
What a mess, tweeted Wendy Williams, which prompted a Carson defender to bring up a dramatic entrance Wendy made on stage. Sometimes your entrance can go just fine, but then it's time for your exit. Remember when President Bush had trouble handling those locked door handles in China? On The View, the hosts recreated the Republican snafu.
Michelle Collins!
As they made their entrance, but when it comes to hailing these chiefs, better hail them louder. Jeannie Mo, CNN, New York.
It is now time for another break. Coming up later in the show, we will take a look at your high school happenings. Times Over Schools Today, we'll be right back.
You and I, we're like fireworks and symphonies exploding in the sky. With you, I'm alive. Like all the missing pieces of my heart, they finally collide. So start time right here in the moonlight, 'cause I don't ever wanna close my eyes. Without you, I feel broke, like I'm half of a whole. Without you, I've got no hand to hold. Without you, I feel torn, like a sail in a storm. Without you, I'm just a sad soul.
Starting over high school happenings, attention students and staff. The school store is now open to serve you. We are stocked with all your Raider apparel needs, including Champion and Under Armour brands. The school store is open every day after school from 1:40 to 2 p.m. We also have Yoo-Hoo, Snapple, and water for $1, as well as many delicious snacks to get you energized for your after-school practices. Stop in soon. It's time to get Raiderized. In the high school theater, there are many opportunities for students to get involved. One place kids are getting involved is with the Asian Heritage Club. Here's a look inside.
I'm Erin Watson from Toms River Schools Today, and we got a chance to take a look at the Asian Club. Let's take a look.
Okay, so you guys are picking.
Usually in our Asian Club meetings, we plan trips to go to places like the Museum of Chinese in America, that's located in New York. We plan movie nights.
Free movie nights, everyone's invited.
And we have an expo coming up. So really most of our meetings we talk about planning and what we can present to people to give them a better understanding of Asian heritage.
Perfect. All right, so that could be like your portion of the presentation.
Asian heritage is, I would say, interesting, especially in America, because it kind of gets mingled with other things. To me, it basically means just seeing other way things can be done, and in this case, seeing how Chinese American things are done.
We're probably going to do like Sunday between 26th.
Black Friday the 26th.
Yeah, 26th.
All right. So at the expo next month, the music videos we're planning on playing will be mostly K-pop videos, such as SHINee, EXO. I think there's gonna be some Girls' Generation in there. We also are going to have origami, just as decorations on the table, and also if you want to learn how to make any of them, we can show you. If there's an Asian heritage class, I definitely want to take it, because Asian heritage is not so common in New Jersey, so it would just be different from the everyday life in Toms River. It would be something new, something to look forward to.
Let's wish the Asian Club lots of luck on their expo. I'm Erin Watson from Toms River Schools Today.
Attention seniors, is your college coming to visit? Please stop by the guidance office to see the list of college visits and when their representative will be coming to High School East. The Computer Club will meet after school every Tuesday in room S33. In the high schools, the freshman classes have been working hard to excel. We stopped in to see the special Freshman Fun Day.
I'm Kayla Howen from Toms River Schools Today. We had a chance to stop in on Freshman Fun Day. Let's take a look.
Now listen up, this is how it's gonna go.
My role was to help organize the way the games were gonna be ran, and I was in charge of the relay race. I mostly teach juniors and seniors, but from my understanding, I think the Freshman Academy is brand new, and Ms. Denoya and the freshman teachers wanted to get some type of camaraderie between all the classes. At the freshman field day, it was the relay race. We dealt with eggs and spoons and dizzy bat and bear crawls.
And the relay race is underway, and here we go. There's some bear crawls. Look at Jason Schneider with his
Bicycle race on the track. And then there was tug of war. And the last one was a musical chairs. I'm not quite too sure. I'm going to say Mr. Goodman. Mr. Goodman and Mr. Diskin came up with it, along with Ms. Denoya as well.
The tug of war is up. I see black. I see blue.
The thing is to bring the classes together, to create competition, to create good morale within the freshman class itself. And I thought it was actually a lot of fun.
The winners are the Black Diamonds! There you go, Black Squad!
Looks like the freshmen had a great time. I'm Kayla Halloran from Toms River Schools Today.
The Spanish National Honor Society will be selling birthday grams for $5 each. You will get a balloon, card, and lollipop, and will be wished a happy birthday on the morning announcement. See Miss Micah in S22 for order forms and questions.
The SAT contest is here. Not only is it a great way to insert some SAT prep into your daily routine, it's also a chance for you to win prizes. Simply log on to SAT.org for the question of the day and drop your answer into the box in either the media center or the guidance department. The more days you enter, the greater chances are of winning. The winner will be chosen on Fridays. See either Dropbox for details. Good luck.
Attention all of our wonderful E students. We are looking for leaders with problem-solving communication skills to work with our teachers and parents to improve school outcomes related to student attendance, behavior, and overall school climate. We are holding individual committee meetings at the end of this month and would love to have you involved. Interested? Check out the flyer in teacher's classroom of the main office for further details. If any freshman still wants to purchase a cert for the class of 2019, the cost is $15. Please bring money to E4A.
Switching to High School North, every Wednesday is Green Day at North. Remember to wear green to help get the word about the need for recycling and energy conservation.
Let's now take a look at what grinds our gears.
We'll be right back.
I'm Kayla Halloran, and what really grinds my gears is drivers who scream at other drivers even though no one can hear them.
I don't get it.
It's now time for us to take a short break. After the break, we take a look at our three-day forecast. For tomorrow, it will be cloudy with a high of 28 and a low of 21. For Saturday, it will be clear and windy with a high of 19 and a low of 1. And finally, Sunday, the sun comes back with a high of 21 and a low of 10.
Times are close today. We'll be right back.
What are you doing this weekend?
Nothing. What?
You
want to
hang out Saturday?
Sure, yeah.
All right.
Bye.
Bye.
I'm falling apart, I'm barely breathing, with a broken heart, that's still bleeding, in the pain, is there healing, in your name, I find meaning.
Ron, you can't drive.
Debbie, I only had 12.
Seems to be the problem, Ossifer.
Sir, have you been drinking tonight?
Starting off sports, a special needs teenager has brought the crowd to its feet at a high school basketball game. He nailed a money shot just seconds before the buzzer. Jason Lamb has the story.
Inside the high school gym at Franklin Road Academy.
There you go, that's better.
It doesn't take long to see how much 19-year-old Robert Lewis loves basketball.
Almost.
He's the manager for the school team, and he even has his own nickname.
Money, good shot.
My nickname is Money Robert.
He works incredibly hard at everything he does.
Robert has Down syndrome, and last Friday night he was at FRA's game against the University School of Nashville, when the head coach invited Robert to suit up and sub in.
I went in and played basketball.
Not only that, the opposing team sent Robert's brother Matthew in to guard him, and then Money Robert got the ball.
I got the ball, there was 5 seconds left in the fourth quarter. I was back there.
A three-pointer that went up and then in. There were still those 5 seconds left on the clock, which explains the delay in what happened next.
After the game, everybody was storming the court. They were picking me up, saying, Ronnie, Robert, I just love it, and I love the players and my coaches.
About that moment that has now gone viral, his parents couldn't believe it.
I've never seen so much love in one gym in my life.
His coaches couldn't believe it.
It's a moment we'll never forget. I don't think we'll ever experience anything more special.
But Robert, he knew it.
I know that ball was going in. And my reaction, I was about to jump up and down. I was so happy that I got that reaction.
If it wasn't clear before Friday night, there's no doubt now. There's a lot more love here than just for basketball.
I just love my family so much, and I just love everyone.
For the guy with the nickname Money Robert, last Friday was priceless.
I just love that moment when everybody was so happy for me.
Wrapping up tonight's show, a homeowner in California wanted to pay special tribute to his late father. In the home he grew up in, he decided to do that through photographs, ones that were big enough to cover an entire house. Reporter Courtney Friel takes us there.
This home covered in photographs is the latest art exhibit to hit Manhattan Beach, at least until it's torn down next month to make way for a brand new condo complex.
And he actually took care of my father when he was getting old.
Gary Sweeney grew up in the house on 35th Street, which his father, Mike, a former Manhattan Beach councilman and mayor, bought back in 1945 for just $5,400, then lived in up until his death in 2000. With great sadness, Gary recently sold the property.
It was a very tough decision, but it was time. The house has fallen apart. We don't have children to pass it on to.
Gary wanted to pay tribute to the home and his dad, who loved photography and took all of these pictures featuring Gary's mom Anita, sister Gail, cousin Mark, and grandmother Maggie in their beloved beach community.
Just loved Manhattan Beach, and there wasn't, all the way up until the day he died, he was involved in something with the community.
And people like Julian Tran, who came up from Orange County with her dog to see the photos, appreciate the Sweeney's memories.
And I love art, and I love photography. That's why I'm out here with him. I take him around, we look at murals all over LA, we drive around, and this is like the perfect combination of both.
And Gary is overwhelmed by the community support for his laborious project, which included scanning the pictures, getting them printed on plywood, then sawing them down to size to screw onto the outside walls. It was no project at Kinko's.
No. I actually have done a lot of large public art pieces, so like putting together a jigsaw puzzle, and it was actually really fun to do.
Remember, if you have a story you would like us to cover, or if you have an announcement about an upcoming event, please send an inter-school mail to the TV studio at High School East, or you can email us at tv21@trschools.com.
Also, please be sure to tune in to TV21 throughout the day to catch this show as we bring you stories from around the school district. Also, please take a look at our website, www.trschools.tv21.com.
That wraps up tonight's show. From Tom's Over Schools Today, I'm Liz Necker.
And I'm Shay Branda. Have a great night.
It may be hard for you to stop and believe, but for you, I'd give it all. Oh, for you.
Kinda sweet like an angel. Got a peanut girl. Kinda sweet like an angel. I'm a born of my one. Well, she ain't no singer. She ain't no star. But she sure does good. And she moves so fast. But the guy in me. Yeah, the guy in jeans. But you keep on pushing. What you take on bed. She counting up your meaning. Counting up your debt. She's a sweet black angel. Not a sweet black slave. Yeah.